Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector. China has 7 and Pakistan has 10 airbases close to Indian border. In the advent of war, India must have capability to destroy these airbases to jeopardize the enemy air forces. However, the airbases are heavily guarded using the air defense system. This is where the role of standoff air-to-surface autonomous weapon systems comes into play, which can destroy the targets from 100 kilometers away. We have already witnessed the use of one such standoff weapon, Spice 2000, during the Balakot strike. However, Spice 2000 was imported from Rafale Advanced Systems. DRDO has also developed the indigenous world-class lightweight high-precision standoff weapon called SAW, or the Smart Anti-Airfield Weapon. The SAW is a long-range precision-guided anti-airfield weapon designed to be capable of engaging ground targets with high precision from a range of 100 kilometers. It is an aircraft-launched advanced precision strike weapon in 125 kg category. It can be used to destroy enemy airfield assets such as radars, bunkers, taxi trucks, runways, aircraft hangars and other reinforced structures within a range of 100 kilometers. Due to its small size, the fighter jets can carry 2 to 4 SAW in its single pod. Unlike the normal bombs, which may not hit the precise target due to the environmental conditions, SAW uses navigation system, which has a higher precision and is cheaper than missiles, which have similar precision. Normal bombs do not have precision at all. They go by wind conditions and weather conditions. However, when you are fighting the enemy, especially bombing an airbase, you cannot keep trying 100 times, as once you have fired, the enemy will know your presence. As the weather and wind conditions change, it is always possible for the bomb to go elsewhere. However, in SAW, the guidance system will use autocorrection to change its course and go and land at the targeted place. This is a sort of guided bomb, and it will be much cheaper than a missile or rocket because it's not having its own propulsion. It makes use of aircraft's propulsion. It can go and land in a place wherever desired. The SAW can currently be launched from Jaguar and Su-30 MBI aircraft. The former is capable of carrying 6 such weapons. There are plans to integrate the weapons with Dassault Rafale as well. SAW has a length of 1.85 meters and weighs close to 125 kgs. The bomb has impressive accuracy with circular error probability CEP less than 7 meters. It uses IN GPS and Gagan for navigation. For those who are not aware of Gagan, it is a GPS-aided geo-augmented navigation jointly developed by ISRO and AAI to provide the best possible navigation service over Indian FIR or Flight Informational Region with capability of expanding to neighboring FIRs. The bomb uses PCB or FCB warheads with programmable impact delay fuse. It has a range greater than 90 km with release parameters of 12.8 km height and 0.9 m, which is pretty impressive. The DRDO India is also working on an advanced version of this bomb called EOSAW or Electro-Optical SAW, similar to Rafale Spice 250. EOSAW variant will make use of imaging infrared rays seeker systems for the terminal homing. The imaging infrared seeker or IR seeker has already been tested against the anti-tank guided missiles NAG, Helena and MP-80GM, Exo-Atmospheric Interceptor PDV and Anti-Satellite Test ASAT. EOSAW will have improved accuracy with circular error probability less than 3 meters. The weapon will have day and night and all weather capabilities with auto target acquisition algorithm. It will be utilizing unique digital scene matching area correlation technology to overcome the GPS jamming. Very soon, DRDO is going to conduct the trials of EOSAW. But this is not it. DRDO is further extending the capability of SAW by using dual seeker, that is, with the use of IIR seeker along with MMW or millimeter wave seeker technology. The one disadvantage with IIR Seeker is that its effectiveness reduces in the battlefield conditions such as dust, smoke, rain, fog, haze, and low cloud cover. This is where MMMW Seeker is used, and it will further boost the accuracy of SAW. This dual seeker variant of SAW will also have artificial intelligence capabilities for tracking and assigning itself both starting and moving targets. The standoff weapon can also initiate self-aware evasive maneuvers if needed. The SAW has already entered into production. The DAC has already approved the procurement of SAW worth Rs. 970 crores for the use by Indian Air Force. This was today's update. Please let us know what is your views about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions about any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind, friends. Please like and subscribe our video if you have not done already. We'll be soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in defense sector.